Qingming is here. Not only is it a festival, it's also a solar term. There are many traditions during Qingming Festival. For example, sweeping the tombs and taking trips. Qingming has many traditions, and today I'm going to try something different. Today I'm going to plant a tree. Planting a tree is an ancient tradition that dates back to the Qing Dynasty. According to legend, the climate is excellent during Qingming Festival, so it's good to plant trees. So that's why it became a tradition to plant trees. I also would like to go and see some beautiful Chinese clothes. So let's go. I am very interested in Chinese clothing, so today I'm going to visit my friend and learn all about it. So let's go. Hi David.
Hello Mark.
I'm here today to learn all about Chinese traditional clothing. Can you please show me around?
Sure, no problem. Let's go.
Okay.
汉服呢，它全称是汉民族传统服饰，然后也就是咱们这个中华民族的传统文化中非常重要的一部分。它呢是随着这个中国的历史发展而发展的，是中国特别具有特色的一种物质文化。然后里面其实不仅包含了中国的很多这个高超的一些纺织啊，各种技艺在里头。 还蕴含了很多中国人独特的一些这种人文情怀和这种独特的社会的氛围，所以才造就这样的一个服饰。那像今天呢，我们很多汉服爱好者呢，主要也是会去穿着和选择这些服饰。那像我们汉代的、近代的、唐代的、宋代的、明代的这些汉服呢，现在也受到很多年轻人的喜欢和追捧。他们很多人呢，也会在日常去穿着我们这些中国的传统服饰。
David, you look nice. You seem to be wearing a very traditional Chinese clothing. Can you please tell me all about it?
那像我今天穿的这一身呢，是这个明制的圆领袍，明圆领。然后它主要就是以这个领子来命名这件衣服，因为我们能看到这个领子它是圆形的。然后这个衣服呢，它实际上它是从唐代的唐圆领发展而来的。然后唐圆领呢，也是在唐代的时候正式的进入了这个华夏的服饰体系。 这个是明代的，这个是一个蟒袍，然后这是个贴里的样式，在明代的时候可能就是，更偏向于像锦衣卫啊或者武将啊这些比较有身份、有社会地位的人。来 ，Mark， 那咱就试一下这个衣服，对，
okay.
先把这个袖子穿上。Right， 然后呢，这边打个结。Wait a minute，Wait a minute。
I've had a different Qingming festival, and I'm amazed. The more I learn about Chinese traditions, the more I want to keep learning and showing you.